Floor is yours, Deryl.
All right, I appreciate that. So the last time I did 2 minutes was just when the pandemic was getting started. And, you know, there was, I did it on the impact, potential impact on commercial real estate. So I figured why not close it out with this. And so what's interesting this time around, and few, many of us in the company have been through many cycles and many shocks in commercial real estate. And so I wanted to go back to the 2008 fall, 2006, 2008 fall. And if you look on the graph, Q1, 2007, every single sector was impacted pretty tremendously with the crisis, financial crisis. Excuse me, the hospitality sector being the worst. And a couple of reasons for that. I think, you know, at that time, everyone was really bullish on commercial real estate. Even though the cost of credit was higher than it is now, it was easier to get financing. And so much of that was driven by the subprime market. And when that failed, everything just kind of failed. And we were in the buying business. We bought at the top of the market and lost everything right around 2009 with another group I was with. So, you know, fast forwarding to today, you can see the trend of every product increasing. And then at the end of this graph, Q1 2020 is when COVID hit. So, you know, the big losers in COVID were hospitality, and that's to be expected, right? It's travel, business, business conferences, et cetera. Hospitality prices fell about 10% overall through Q2021. Office declined about 4% overall through Q2021. But, you know, nobody knows what's going to happen with the office sector, right? I mean, it's there. A lot of companies are subletting space, and the current office vacancy today is about 21%, and that's impacting value of office. Retail prior to COVID was being hammered by online sales. Online sales went from 16% in 2019 to about 21% or 20% 2020. The big winners in retail were grocery anchored centers and drugstore anchored centers, needs-based retail. Other non-essential retail got hammered, but I think that the growth of grocery anchored and drugstore related really kind of helped solidify retail and not to have so many losses. The big winner through all of this is industrial. And much of that is driven by warehouse spaces needed for all the online shopping. And you can see the industrial market has been on fire up through, from 2009 to today. Much of the downturn, you know, as we all know, was mitigated by PPE and stimulus money. And, you know, thankfully, our business and the finance industry, we've done extremely well. I mean, I think this is Tauro's best year. Other capital advisors are doing deals left and right. So the anticipated downfall, even with hospitality, did not really happen. So I think we dodged a bullet this time around. That's really all I had.
Thanks, Deryl. That was great.